Sharmila Joshi is with us and Avinnash Gorakssakar is joining in as well. Good morning, both of you. Thanks very much. Sharmila, to you, I should not ask whether the market, why the market will do, but why the market is trading, right?
I know.
Is the right question to ask. Not just to you, actually, but to a lot of people.
Yes, gone are those days long, long ago when we used to get that year-end break, which very few people remember now.
Yeah.
But yes, absolutely, that should be the question.
Yeah, I mean, but I guess that's the question for exchanges, right? I mean, actually, it's interesting. I think India and Pakistan are the only two markets trading on the 1st of January. I mean, God knows why. But most of the rest of the world is shut, by the way. Anyway, one minute, 30 seconds to go for start. Any thoughts on how the market, what the market will do, Sharmila?
Well, honestly, you know, we were just chatting and I think that you shouldn't really be looking at these markets because, we are, you know, last couple of days to expiry, last couple of days of the year, and a lot of people are out of the market. A lot of significant players are out of the market. Next January, again, you're going to see, you know, come 10 January, you're going to see a new earnings season. So I think, you know, it's best to really wait it out till then. And because that's really what will give you a true sense of how really market perceives, you know, this level that we've gotten to. I would really expect markets to correct from here. But as I'm saying, you know, it's best to really wait for all FIs to come back, get a sense of what their mood is towards India going ahead, and wait for earnings to start. Because I think, you know, that's really going to be the big thing to, big theme for me going ahead is going to be really earnings more than anything else. Because I think everything else should be discounted at this point in time.
Yeah. But your gut tells you market should correct from here, right?
Yes, I think that
maybe
we should see a correction and you should use that correction to start buying stocks which you like, but stocks where earnings are showing recovery and not like some expectation that, you know, that some regulation will come in their favor or something.
Okay. Tomorrow is expiry, by the way. And as we were pointing out earlier, compared to, I mean, short rollovers, it's completely reversed now. So long rollers will have to chase the market now. That's the situation. Compared to average rollovers of 43-45%, market rollover is now 50%. I mean, it's quite unusual, but I guess that's because people want to wrap up the business and then take a day off or two. 45 points on the Sensex, 10 points, 11 points on the Nifty right now. HDFC is up 0.6%. BHEL starts up about a quarter. Bank of Baroda is up 0.5%. NTPC is down about 0.1%. Ambuja is up barely nothing. Bharti is up 0.75%. ONGC is up 0.15%. Hindalco is up 0.5%. Not very much, at least nothing large to report yet. 6 points on the Nifty, 20 points on the Sensex. And I think the Nifty is now almost exactly at its 50-day simple moving average as well, which to some is should be a bit of a hurdle. And you know, it's been up 5% over the last 15 days or so, 15th of December starting. Lever, Yes Bank, some up, some down, but all mostly largely flat. Lupin, nothing decisively up or lower. BPCL, Ultratech, you got Maruti, Indusind Bank, Asian Paints is starting up about 0.25%. United Spirits at the bottom of the screen is down 2.5%. So they've applied to BIFR to be declared as a SIC company, but it's mandatory. It's a bit of a technicality. If you lose more than 50% of the peak net worth, as it has over the last 4 years, you have to apply to the BIFR. You've got to file an application with the BIFR. Stocks down 2.5, 2908, but will it stay down? We'll see. Jet Airways is up 0.65, 651. SpiceJet, Interglobe, I think is about 1186. It's flattish, has done remarkably well. What else? I guess very little. HDFC Bank is up 0.25%, 1080. They've cut their base rate to 9.3%. So HDFC and SBI are at 9.3, ICICI at 9.35. SR Oil, I think the delisting price is out and that's it's pretty much around the traded price. All Cargo 1% higher, 214.3 is small news flow. Bharti is up nearly 1%, 338 or so. 11 points on the Nifty, Sensex up 50 points. Let's put the most active stocks across the board, through and through, up for you on the air, and we can pick some out as well. But let's continue with the conversation here. Avinash, where do you stand? You agree with Sharmila? Maybe the market heads lower from here?
No, I think the ground reality is totally different. And I think to a certain extent, Sharmila is right, because I think earnings recovery is going to take at least two more quarters. And at least, you know, from the I think from the events point of view, I think the markets would obviously look at, you know, the coming budget and the railway budget. So some action could be seen in the month of January, but I think the real thrust possibly could come after the budget. I think probably January could start off on a slow start, but probably, you know, move up based on kind of pre-budget kind of expectation. So I would be also more comfortable once I see an earnings recovery. I think clearly we have not seen it in the second quarter, and December and March quarter is also not going to be completely different. So I think it's better to stay cautious. This move is largely because of short covering and more of NAV activity. So I think better to wait and watch.
Better to wait and watch. Any ideas, Avinash?
I think clearly, you know, from the auto component space, there have been some stocks, you know, some smaller stocks, you know, stocks like Jamna Auto, which is a very large player in the parabolic spring market. I think for a very long period, you know, this company remained, you know, a big underperformer. But now with the kind of growth we are seeing in the commercial vehicle space, I think they've got large unutilized capacity. So probably, you know, that is one big kicker for them. And they are large vendors to almost all the large OEMs, especially the domestic CV players, as well as the MNC, you know, CV players who are operating in India. So around 135, 140, this could be a good value pick, again, from a year's kind of perspective.
He's done well recently, right?
In fact, numbers have been
pretty good.
I spoke to
Jamna about 2 months back.
Yeah.
And they said they'll do about 10 rupees in EPS this
year. Yeah, roughly about 9.5 to 10 rupees.
So it should, you still...
I think clearly, you know, I think hopefully if the CV market grows by, say, at least 14-15%, which most of the OEM, you know, manufacturers have hinted, I would not be surprised if, you know, earnings recovery kicks in, because clearly operating leverage would kick in, because they don't have to add large capacity to their, you know, asset, you know, base as of now. At least for the next 12 to 15 months, they've got adequate capacity to, you know, cater to FY17 kind of top line.
Yeah. Anything else? Any other names?
I think clearly, you know, from the...
We can put up Jamna Auto. I mean, let's get out of the wall. Let's look at Jamna Auto, which Avinash is talking about. I think it's on the NSE as well?
Yeah, it is. NSE, BSE.
Let's put the stock up on the BSE. I think it's listed on the NSE as well. But anyway, let's look at it. 141 or so. And it's done very well over the last, I guess... It's been doing well. Last 3 days, it's up 10%. But over a period of time, of course, there was a fair bit of selling. There was a large PE player which was getting out. There was continuous selling. That selling got over. And from that point, from about 120-ish or 115 or so, which was the low, it's come back to about 140 or so. 141 now. So that's Jamna Auto, which Avinash is talking about. Avinash, go on. What else?
You know, from the fact that, you know, Motherson Sumi, again, from the auto component space, we had heard a lot of negative news flow arising after the Volkswagen issue. But if one sees the business model, typically, you know, I think the kind of products they cater to the passenger car market in India, especially, and, you know, markets like US and Europe. My sense is, I think the current price, you know, if one takes a medium to longer term view, I think earnings recovery will definitely kick in. Has been, you know, very investor friendly in terms of dividends and bonuses. So I would say that this could be a good portfolio pick at the current level. I think from a 12 to 15 month horizon, you know, Motherson Sumi is another player which we feel is going to be showing good earnings recovery in the year FY17 as well as FY18.
Or is it all clear now? What is the impact of Volkswagen and...
No, I think probably, you know, I think even if the impact does come in to a large extent, Prashant, this news has been discounted. I don't know how much impact, you know, the FY16 earnings would take. But clearly, I think, you know, this is not going to be an event which is going to reoccur now again in FY17. And Volkswagen has mentioned that, you know, for certain other models, you know, the supply pipeline is going to continue as, you know, earlier targeted.
Wait till at least the third quarter results are out?
I would not be presumed, because, you know, clearly I think this is one stock where I would say that already some heavy selling has happened. Mm. Probably, you know, some investors who want to take a cautious stand.
When did this entire story on Volkswagen break? Pre-Q2 results or?
Pre-Q2.
So in Q2 we saw...
No, I think Q2 probably nothing of that impact came in. So probably the impact could be felt in Q3. And probably, you know, you know, after that possibly it could be a one-time kind of effect.
Mm. Anything else? Jamna, Motherson...
Actually, in certain cement companies, you know, something like a Ramco Cement or typically even a JK Cement, you know, these are stocks which we feel, you know, probably FY17 could be a good year for cement stocks, and especially the smaller cement companies. Clearly, I think, you know, one should...
JK and which one?
Ramco.
Ramco. JK is north-based.
Yeah,
right?
North-based. And Ramco is largely south-based.
Okay. I know somebody I was talking to was saying that north-based cement players complete shambles.
Yeah, I think because, you know, at least in terms of, you know, JK Lakshmi, you know, has done pretty well. So, at least the numbers at least are pretty good. Although, you know, south, one good thing is that the prices have actually improved. Yeah. And there's good scope for possibly, you know, FY17, you know, for these prices.
Yeah, south is absolutely, and the stocks are reflective of that.
Exactly.
But north-based, I don't know, I mean, some of the smaller players, they say that prices have collapsed.
Prices have collapsed. In fact, south is definitely much better positioned.
Yeah, anything apart from that? Any other sector, stocks?
I think typically, you know, the large cap, you know, I would still like to bet on something like autos, you know, more on the passenger car and on the commercial vehicle side. And I think one could definitely look at something like an Ashok Leyland or a Tata Motors. I think Tata Motors also looks attractive, you know, if one takes the longer term kind of potential. I think the Chinese factor also seems to have been discounted largely. And I think in terms of valuations, once the domestic market picks up, hopefully, you know, JLR also kicks in. I too would not be surprised if Tata Motors could be a good outperformer.
You know, one trigger, so China, of course, JLR, for CVs, commercial vehicles, one thing which I think everybody is watching out for, at least in the industry, and Jamna Auto, I spoke to, also said this, the government, and this is not new, but there's been talk for the last couple of years now that maybe the government should restrict the age of trucks on the road to 15 years. I mean, it was said 10 years, then not for 15 years. Now, we've not heard, and there was some news reports recently saying that in the next 15 days, the government will come out with a notification. But if something like that is done, it's going to be difficult to do. But if it is done, it almost adds the demand worth about 1.5 years of commercial vehicles sold in the country. So that's something to watch out for. Shamila, anything you like, any ideas you want to share?
Yes, I would agree. I think that for me, even you know, to just take off from what Avinash was saying, is that the whole commercial vehicle space does look interesting, because, you know, I think there are a couple of pockets in the market where numbers have been good, and I think this is definitely one of those, and we've seen it in stock performance. So having said that, you know, probably don't be in a hurry to buy, but I definitely like an Ashok Leyland at this price, because we are seeing that that the stock is consolidating around these levels, and month-on-month numbers continue to be strong. This is definitely, I think, one stock to look at. I think the other sector which I really like at this point in time, continue to like rather, is pharma. Because I think, you know, the sheer... the kind of US FDA activity that we are seeing sort of, to me, proves that now Indian companies are doing serious business overseas. So from that perspective, I do like some of the larger listed stocks, because we have seen corrections there, like a Sun Pharma at this price.
Yeah.
But I do like slightly mid-cap plays like a Shilpa or a Marksans Pharma. I think, you know, those stocks can also be looked at. Then I think, you know, the other...
What is Shilpa Medicare, right?
Yeah,
what does it do? Is it a...
That's also sort of oncology-specific kind of a pharma play.
Okay.
And largely exports, so, you know, they sort of benefit from that.
Okay.
You know, their market sort of never really... you never really see their market kind of going down.
Okay.
Fortunately, unfortunately. Okay. But from a numbers perspective, they do
APIs or generics, formulations?
APIs.
Okay. Shilpa Medicare and...
Marksans.
Okay. Marksans is also APIs.
Yeah. And I think the other interesting space for me is the microfinance companies. You know, I think that a lot of regulation has changed in their favor. Now, unfortunately, we've seen too big a run-up in SKS Micro, because that has always been a stock that I've liked.
Yeah.
But I think as a space, you know, that's beginning to...
But any other names there?
I like a Mannapuram to a lesser extent. But, you know, so not just microfinance, I think even some of the housing finance companies, you know, sort of look good, because their cost of finance has come down over a period of time. So I think even an LIC Housing Finance is a stock that I like.
But these have all done very well already, right? In 2015.
Yes, but I think LIC Housing Finance to a lesser extent. Mannapuram also hasn't actually really moved much.
Yeah.
So possibly, you know, take a greater bet on those than an SKS, because SKS has gone down and sort of recovered back to old levels. So.
Any thoughts on something like a Adani Port, which has come off 30-35% from just a quarter back?
So I think a lot of these stocks also, what is happening is that because they've seen such huge run-ups, you know, they're now finding it difficult really to make the next move up. You know, like just that analysis that we've gotten overnight, you know, which said that how have commodities or markets fared. You know, they say mid-caps have gone up 10% in the last year. But honestly, if you see individual stocks haven't really shown that performance. So I think, you know, in some of these stocks, you need to take a bit of a breather, or if you buy, you have to know, which is what I said even about Ashok Leyland, that, you know, you need to give it a little time now to really make the next leg up. Of course, I think Adani Port is not a stock that I like as much as meaning it's not a stock that I recommend. But I think, you know, some of these stocks of that sort are really going through that sort of consolidation kind of phase where old investors who made money are exiting and, you know, you're sort of waiting for, you know, the earnings to sort of bring back that valuation back in favor of these stocks.
Adani Port, Avinnash?
I think longer term, Prashant, definitely the business model is robust. And I think in the shorter term, you know, I think markets would like to see what kind of earnings trajectory we could see for, say, FY17 and FY18. But I think overall, I think within the infra, you know, port space, it's a very dominant player. So definitely, you know, as a long term kind of portfolio pick, it definitely is good. You know, it's come off its high. It trades at about 30-35% to its high. But if you really ask me in the short term how the stock would perform, it's a little difficult call. But probably FY17 and FY18, once volumes pick up, you know, the broad economy also takes off. I think you could possibly see good amount of upside here.
Lesser coal import. So that's the problem. I mean, it's
but how long, Prashant? You know, this is also
more coal is not turning out to be great news for generally the right, Coal India is suffering.
Exactly.
No demand for
In fact,
coal.
Both
companies are suffering.
I was just looking at another stock yesterday, you know, something like GMDC. You know, if you see the financials, Prashant, excellent numbers. Last year, 500 crores profit, a 4% dividend yield.
This is GMDC?
GMDC.
Okay.
It's a Gujarat state government funded company, 74% holding. Now, this is a, according to me, this is a good value pick if somebody has the time and patience. You know, it trades at very low valuations,
this is Gujarat,
very good
mineral development.
Yeah, mineral development. It's into lignite. But the point is, you know, they have got large cash reserves, virtually debt free. And I think, you know, once the stock gets, you know, the trigger, I think probably, you know, they could possibly invest
what,
in some.
What is the trigger? But
no, I mean, the point is they want to get into some sort of power generation apart from lignite. They've started, you know, cooperating with other private sector players. And the best part is last 4 to 5 years continuously, you know, 150% dividend. So, you know, at least from that perspective, you know, earnings are more or less protected, and it's not like a typical metal company. So probably, you know, here one could see value, but, you know, the point is stocks like Adani Port or, you know, probably the high beta stocks. This is a stock which probably doesn't have last that amount of liquidity, but very well funded, very strong cash flows.
Any of you have looked at Piramal Enterprises, by the way? It's a bit of out of the blue, but
no, not really.
Shamila?
I not have it.
No, I'm afraid not.
Okay. But that's the trick, right? Look at things which no one else is looking at.
I have this stock actually, so possibly that's one of the reasons why I don't really
You own the name.
Okay. But you know, so you hear of the kind of investments that they are doing. And
but it's
all
there's no coherent. I mean, I've not taken the time to look at
it. You know, so that's the thing that you get, that you aren't really. They seem to have made interesting investments, and it seems to. It seems a good thing to believe that their investments will pay off. But I think, you know, it's a, that way it's a long-term story. So I think the stock has recovered, if I'm correct, from about 600, 700 levels to about, you know, the 1,000 levels that it went to. But I think, again, you know, this is going to sort of consolidate here before it, because it, those things have to deliver, you know, what they've sort of invested in.
Fair enough. Any other, Shamila, any other ideas? Slightly longer term, maybe.
Yeah, so I think along the same lines, you know, then I think within the same space, you have to then look for stocks. So, you know, within the pharma space, like I've always liked a Biocon, for instance. There, I think, you know, you did see that.
What's up with Biocon? I mean, you know, that drug, the approval they got.
I don't know where this sudden interest has come from, but very honestly.
The drug, by the way, is 200 crores a year in India.
Yeah.
There are 9 players.
So it didn't seem like very big news to me, but, you know, you suddenly saw the stock rally from there. But But, you know, if you see from a valuation perspective, it is trading at a bit of a discount to other players within that space. And the reason that was always given was that, you know, they were not delivering those numbers. But last 2-3 quarters, we have seen that stability come in, you know, the kind of numbers they've been able to deliver. And Syngene also has been something that is now sort of, you know, one of the triggers that was expected to happen, which has now happened. But I don't really know where this sudden buying interest has come from to take the stock from that 480 levels to, you know, the current 500 plus levels. Yep. But I had a target in any case of closer to 600 on the stock. So, you know, those are the kind of names that I like.
Okay, fair enough. We'll wrap it up here. Shamila, thank you very much for joining us. Avinnash, appreciate you joining in. Good speaking with both of you here on the channel. Let's take a very quick, actually, and let me wish you both a very happy New Year as well.